today.
Not today.
So sure, and you had a name for me.
Oh.
Yeah, what was that name?
Special friend.
What's wrong with that?
Special friend. I was her special friend for 6 months.
But you're special.
It's okay. I love being special. It didn't matter because I was in heaven. I'm in heaven. And my heart beats so that I can hardly speak. And I seem to find the happiness I see. When we're out together dancing cheek to cheek.
I won't dance, don't ask me. I won't dance, don't ask me. I won't dance, mister, with you. My heart won't let my feet do things that they should do.
You know what?
What?
You're lovely. You know what? So lovely. And know what you do to me. I'm like an ocean wave that's bumped on the shore. I feel so absolutely stumped on the floor.
When you dance, you're charming and you're gentle.
Thanks.
Especially when you do the continental. But this clearly isn't purely mental.
For that rest us, I'm not a specialist. And that's why
heaven, I won't dance, why should I? I won't dance, how
and
can
my
I?
Heart
I won't
so
dance,
that I speak.
I know that music leads the way to romance.
So if I hold you in my arms,
I won't dance
with me. I want my arms about you. The charms about you will carry me through to heaven.
I might dance.
What?
Well, ask me.
Wait, really? Will you dance, madame, with me?
I know that music leads the way to romance.
So if I hold you in my arms,
I might dance!
So we have a little special game that we want to play with you.
Woohoo!
Games, it's so fun. So you know how there's beverages? You guys should all have a beverage. And if you don't, you should get one in intermission. But we were thinking that maybe every time we kiss tonight, you guys take a sip. And then our jokes will be funnier. So, that's probably like about 5 sips, I think, as of now, when we just started the show.
So. Let's practice.
Good job. Okay, so, oh wait, will you grab me my water?
Oh yeah.
Okay, I love you. yes, so I did call you my special friend, back to that. But I do believe I was the first one to say I love you, so I win some points with that one.
That's right. You did say, I think I might maybe love you.
It's still I love you!
I love you too.
In my mind,
First I think about you, then I think about me loving you, then I think about you and me deciding we could be one. It's crazy, I know. I wrestle with my pillow all last night, then I look at you and I know I chose right. Life's a very long road, and the crossroads come up right away, and it's sure hard to know which way to go when you've barely begun. And oh, the roads you leave behind can shine so bright. And I look at you, and I know I chose right. Now maybe we don't mean that much, you and I. And maybe our balloon will never fly. And maybe no one cares if we let things go by. And maybe it doesn't matter if we live or die. But if I'm making promises to you, the C train, but then I would, for some reason, I would just get drawn to the one train. And then I don't know how this happened, but I ended up on your block. Knowing I'm on the street where you bother me. For there's nowhere else on earth that I would rather be. Let the time go by, I won't care if I can be here on the street where you live. People stop and stare, they don't bother me. For there's nowhere else on earth that I would rather be. Let the time go by, I won't care if I can be here on the street where you live.
Amazing. I'm gonna marry that. Okay. Oh, anyway, let's talk. Oh, hey, Austin, do you remember our first date?
I do.
Very romantic. It was there was a meteor shower that night, and so I came to pick up Caroline, and we were gonna go to a park and just talk and get to know each other and check out some...
Yeah, just talk.
Just...
just like...
Just talk.
And just lands a little bit. Anyway, yes, it was a very romantic plan. But do you remember what happened before the date?
I've chosen to forget that.
So, I'm going to set the story up for you. I was home in D.C. I am from Maryland, for those of you who don't know that. And my parents were moving out of home, so the new home was in a little bit of disarray. There were boxes and paintings still leaning up against the walls. And I had made it very clear to my parents. I was like, I am not a child. Please don't come downstairs. I don't want you to meet this guy. You know, he's new, and I'm, you know, I'm 24. I've been on my own for a little bit. You know, don't embarrass me. So I made a big deal about it. My mom and I had dinner and like a little bit of wine and that night, and then I was like, okay, go to bed. This guy's coming over. He's gonna come get me. So he's on his way over, and everybody's asleep. I'm like, you know, nervous. He's coming to get me for our first romantic date, and he rings the doorbell, and I go in into the door, and our very old dog at the time gets up, and he comes in the door, and she doesn't recognize him, and she gets up and proceeds to knock over this huge painting and just slams on the ground, shards of glass everywhere. And my dad from upstairs is like, what the hell was that? And like screams it. And so I'm like, Austin's just standing there with his mouth like, oh, wide open. And my mom, like, you know, we had had some wine, so like in her little tipsy state, like comes down and is like, is everything okay? Her not coming down. And so, and then Austin starts, you know, trying to overcompensate. He's like, the dog got scared. And my mom goes, yes, Austin, blame the dog. So immediately, Austin was getting crap from my parents, you know, my dad in bed and my mother just, you know, being her little sweet self. So she, we're cleaning up the glass, we're like getting to know, I introduce Austin to my mother. And then my brother, I must have heard me make a big deal about not coming downstairs. He's like a 6'2 wrestler type, comes downstairs in his boxers, walks past Austin, goes to the refrigerator, drinks milk out of the carton, which, who does that anymore? He went, drank it out, put it back in the fridge, walks past Austin again, and goes, sup, and just walks up the stairs. So, this was Austin's first meeting of my family, which now I wouldn't have it any other way because it's so funny, and it's, our life is going to be filled with laugh and love and laughs and love and all the things fun. So it's, couldn't have asked for a better introduction. I want to laugh. I wanna cry. auction. Go get another beverage.
We should all get a silent auction, wine, cheese, beer. Yeah, have at it. We'll see you soon. Make sure that you come to Act Two equipped.
Maybe I could try it.
Sure.
Help me if I screw up.
Fill me up with the heat, with the noise. Hello? Nope. I don't know, you can hear me.
Yeah.
So Caroline, thank you. I will say this. One of my favorite roles you've ever played was Alpha. And you were actually my first Alpha. I was saying we did for the first time when I saw your opening night. And it was amazing. I mean, this girl looks good in any color, green, whatever. But you were phenomenal, and it was so great. I got to see that 10 times, you know, perks of dating a witch.
You know, a lot of people ask me if I would ever go back to Wicked if you were playing Fiero. So why don't we give the people what they want?
And if he was here, she'd probably say it to his face. But he Fear is like in Act One, and then he's gone for a while. It's kind of like Rolf, you know, in Act One, just kind of comes in and messes up things. So he comes, he goes away during the intermission and stuff, and Caroline would always come home and be like, he had broccoli breath again.
He didn't like broccoli.
But I also wanted to go up to him and be like, hey dude, you don't have to like repel her. Like, I'm cool if you like do a scene with her. I'm not like,
I would complain about my favorite because it wasn't you. I wish it was you.
You want this?
Sure. So, yes, doing Wicked was such a blessing, and I'm so grateful for that time. And I gotta tell you, I don't know if I could have gotten through the 9 months of playing that role without you, Austin Colby. It was kind of actually like being on tour all over again, because I would come home from the show and wouldn't be able to speak to anybody. So him and I would have vocal rest games where we would do dub smashes. So our Instagram is filled with dub smashes. And if you don't know what a dub smash is, it's basically just lip syncing and making tons and tons of videos. And so we perfected our dub smashing during those 9 months. I was not like it, but I was grateful for the time, but ready to say goodbye to it after those 9 months. So thank you, Wicked.
Oh,
finally decided my future lies. I finally decided my future lies beyond the yellow brick road. We have a fun little fact.
Yeah, shameless plug. I'm in the Sound of Music right now. Sound of Music, we've got some love trap bands I see here.
Oh my gosh, the love trap children!
So they, we're there. James, what's up? What's up, brother?
Yay!
We are at the Kennedy Center until July 16th, so please, please come see us. It's a great show.
It's amazing.
It's a great show.
I've seen that quite a bit.
Yeah.
I think I'm on 11 or 12.
Yeah.
Thank you for clapping for me for seeing our show. But we have a fun fact. Both of us, Austin and I, have played nuns in The Sound of Music.
That's right. So before, I'm playing Rolf right now, but before I played Rolf, I understood Rolf. And that track, it plays a Nazi and a party guest and a nun at the wedding. And so I chose, you know, when Jack O'Brien tells you to put on a habit, you do it. So, my coworkers were sitting next to me and I was significantly, like, vertically excelling. And so I decided that, okay, I'm going to make an acting choice. I'm going to have a little bit of a slouch. So Jack O'Brien called me Sister Mary Osteoporosis. But once we got to tech and, you know, under the lights and with the habit on, he said it was a little distracting. So I just was really tall.
So we had Sister Mary Osteoporosis.
Uh-huh.
And then I was 13 years old with orange and green braces, playing soprano postulate nun. So we were busted nuns, both of us played busted nuns in The Sound of Music. And I auditioned for The Sound of Music many times in my life, and I always wanted to play Liesel. And I was always too tall, or too short, or too young, or too old.
You still sound pretty upset about that.
I'm not mad.
You wait, little girl. On an empty stair. Your fate to turn the light on. Your life, little girl, is an empty page that men will want to write on.
To write.
You are 16, going on 17, baby, it's time to think. Better beware, be canny and careful, baby, you're on the brink. You are 16, going on 17, fellows will fall in line. Eager young lads and roués and cats will offer you food and wine. Totally unprepared. Face a world of men. Timid and shy and scared are you of things beyond your ken. You need someone older and wiser telling you what to do. I am 17 going on 18. I'll take care.
Bachelor D.
thank yous. Thank you, Monumental Theater Company, for asking us to be here. Thank you, Mike Blank, for talking to us this evening. Thank you to all of you for coming out and supporting
us,
our wedding, and theater. It's pretty awesome. Have I missed anybody?
I don't know. Our parents who birthed us.
Yeah, if you participated in the silent auction, make sure to hang out afterwards and see if you won. And also, I think the bar's still open.
Oh yeah. So hang out and have a little fun for a little while.
We'll see you out there.
I love you so much.
I love you too.
There were bells on the hill, but I never heard them ringing.
No, I never heard them at all till there was you.
There were birds in the sky, but I never. Yeah.